All right, let's go. You're welcome. That was like 30 seconds of her just climbing a ladder. Okay. Oh no. Oh, it's gonna be like last time. Shit. I didn't think that through. Now I gotta wait for her to climb down for 30 seconds as well. Life is cruel. Life is cruel. Is she at least climbing? No. I don't- who designed her AI to not want to be on the ladders at the same time as you? Like, I understand the point of that. You don't want her to block your way up or down. But, if I'm going down, she should go down, and if I'm going up, she should go up. That would solve a lot of problems. Also, if she went at the same speed as you, or went faster than you, that'd be great. But, again, I guess you have to attribute it to the game's old-timiness. Right? They didn't have the last 10 to 15 years of companion kind of games to lead them and go, yep, this is more appreciable than everything else. And that makes it so you end up having a lot of the beginning situations, right? Like, these are the pioneer moments of, hey, how fun is it to literally do an escort mission for an entire game? And the answer is, it varies. Do I have to fight again in this room? I'd like not to. I just want to go to the gate. That's all. Alright. I'm surprised that we made it all the way down here safely. I feel like that's a bad omen, though. Like, hey, you made it down to the gates without any kind of enemy coming to mess you up? Boom. Giant monster. We're gonna save before we do anything like this. The solar-powered gates to freedom might be a trap. Like, for all I know, we actually could have helped her. Yorda's mother, that is. Like, it turns out, oh, by the way, you powered up a super death machine. The gates aren't gonna open. No, they're gonna fire out a laser beam into the world and destroy it. There is no village to go back home to, or forest to hide out in. It's all over now. She's getting hit by lightning, or if she's hitting the door with lightning. I guess it's her. Uh-oh. We should probably go. There is a bridge! Yeah, this feels like it was a little bit too easy. Something's gonna happen. Also, Yorda's hair went white. Oh, that looks worrisome. You gonna be okay? I mean, she's still capable of... Oh, nope, she just fell. Come on, Yorda. We're almost out of here. We just have to cross the really big bridge. and we can get out! I mean, I don't know what's out there for either of us. I'm banished from my village. They were literally willing to lock me up for eternity and let me die out in there. I'm gonna walk so you don't have to fall anymore, okay? We can take a little bit slow if it means that you won't have to fall anymore. Oh, shit. Oh no! Is it doing exactly what I said was gonna happen? Me fall into the water? Oh no. Yoda! Ah! Girl, this is how come I said you had to work out! It's so you can pull me up too! What is that? Oh no. Yoda, please! Well, rest in peace, us. I wonder if I could have just stayed on the other side of the bridge and just, like, watch things happen. But I made my choice. And we're gonna wake up. Totally fine. Farewell. No. We have to go back. Oh god, this place looks terrible. Wait, I landed on something? Okay, no, I should be dead. It's one thing to land in the water and have a potential chance to survive if you hit it at just the right angle for it to not basically be like hitting cement. But actually landing on a piece of metal? No, my bones are broken. I don't think it's even possible for it to have a chance to not be broken. But we are like a demon, well. We are covered in horns. Okay. I'm gonna check this out. I was trying to climb up this, but I guess I can't. I guess I could try and jump? Ah, alright, that works. I don't like the idea of it, because, this is treacherous. I mean, we can already see some of these things have fallen down in the past. Oh god. Are these, like, torture prison cell things? Like, you put a bunch of prisoners inside of them, and they just live a terrible, awful life inside of them because, oh god, they're constantly hanging over death? Like that? That's funny. I am actually now gonna have to retry all the way back because I went slightly to the right. Actually, oh wow. Wow! This game actually has checkpoints? That is astounding. I mean, that's good that they at least considered it for this one bit, right? It'd be weird if you died and had to go through that cutscene. It would kind of diminish the effect of that cutscene, of losing Yorda and her just kind of getting captured by her mother just as you were about to escape. It would suck if you just saw it again and were like, oh no, not this time, no, Yorda, oh, alright. I know what's happening now, but with that said, I predicted that shit so hard. There was no way we were going to be able to escape on the first attempt of opening up the ancient gates. Alright, what are we missing here? Oh, look at that! An underground area with a bunch of machines, huh? Gee, I wonder where we might end up. Perchance, would we end up on a spinning drum machine? with a ladder next to it? Sure would be interesting, wouldn't it? Okay. Let us yank this around. Obviously, we'd need it. Don't know for what! Okay. But I might as well push it down. On you. Okay. No. Don't jump up. I think I have to push this across and then jump along the way. Oh, I can actually pull it while it's in the water. Oh, cool. We get our wood pellets, our wood pellet jumping puzzles super early on in life. Okay. That means this metal-ish looking box has to be empty or something. Like, just hollow. Which, to be fair, I guess that's most boxes by design. They're meant to to hold things, usually. But sometimes you see these things, and I just think to myself, oh, that is filled completely with something. Okay, I'm gonna drag this in advance, just in case there's something... Damn it. I need... Grab onto the box, kid. Okay. Now, we saw we had a chain that we lowered. And if I had to give a guess, I think I gotta jump onto that immediately. At least that's the first thing I'm gonna do. I saw that there's a little bit of land to the left. But I don't think we need it. Not right now. Okay. Let's get back up to solid ground. Or get faked out by the world, I don't know. This place is spooky. It's nighttime now, it's raining outside, you have a constant waterfall. I wonder if the areas are gonna change now because of the rain. I don't know what this is doing. Oh, connected! Neat! Okay, so now I have to go over that side. So it would have been a waste of time if I'd come here just a bit earlier. I'd be going nowhere. Okay, this should be easier than the water wheel, right? Just... Damn it. Time it with my jumps. There. And then drop down. Easy peasy. Still incredibly glad that this place is in the perfect state of destruction and decay for me to be able to get across it. Like, if they made 3 to 5 ways, well, no, 5 is a little bit much, but 2 to 3 ways to, like, get across an area, that would make it at least more believable in some nicer senses, but whatever. Okay. Am I supposed to jump down? Or climb up. Okay, I'm just gonna drop down and see if maybe I cross over here. Ooh. This looks perilous. Like you could fall out from underneath me at any time. Well, now that we've gotten to a place where they want to use checkpoints, this would be the perfect moment to start actually upping the stakes of climbing decaying structures. But I guess they don't need to go full, like, Uncharted or Tomb Raider on us just yet. Still, I'd be scared if I knew these things would fall out from under me. What does that sound? Is that the water wheel? Yes, it is. It sounds like a bird. It's like... Ee-de-de-de. Which I guess is just the sound of the metal. Uh-oh. I was about to say, now what? We have to do the same thing! It was just a matter of perspective. way! Yep, I was right. There's the ladder we saw from super earlier in the game. Well, super earlier, it was like an hour ago. Oh, shit. What do I do now? Oh! I climb back up. This is not a ladder to get out of the area. This is a ladder to get back here and try to jump across the spinning gears. Lovely. I love this. I'm ready. Okay! That's my fault. I shouldn't have tried jumping. I should just try to... No, I have to jump. If I walk, I'll just fall. Sometimes it'd be nice if you could just, like, snap the camera to a legitimate more third-person angle. So that, you know, just in case you make it to a ladder before the game is ready for it, you just have the camera right there. Not whatever. Okay. Yep. Okay, we made it. We're good. We're off. Fantastic. Now we can start making our way back into the castle. Okay, this is too dark. I'm gonna die. Like, fall off to my death or something. Oh my god. I thought they wanted me to navigate just like a permanently dark cave. It was just the entrance. Well, we didn't see those before, holy crap. Hey, I remember that bridge. Oh, I don't like changing camera angles in the middle of a jump. It makes me think I just died. Like, I missed the jump, and now I'm just gonna plummet. Oh boy. I'll give him credit. The area doesn't have to be literally crumbling out from underneath me to make it seem perilous. Damn it. Okay. I was trying to jump across the way. A little bit earlier than they intended me to. And the game said, nope. You're trying to jump a little bit earlier than we intended you to. You're just gonna go straight up, my friend. You can't jump backwards unless we want you to. Jerks. Okay, I gotta be careful here. This is round, so I should try and stay in the middle. Although you walk faster when you're actually on top of it. It's weird in the middle. Maybe it's just a placebo thing, but it feels like... When I'm like this, fast. When I'm like this, slow. Doesn't matter, this won't be here for long. Holy hell, this is rusted up. How long has this place been here? Also, hey, I'm glad to see more of, like, the more advanced stuff, right? It's one thing to build a giant stone castle. It's another thing to have pipes and things going everywhere, and irrigation, and just plumbing. Congratulations! You live in a slightly okay place. Alright. We're making it back into the castle. We're officially on stony ground. We're just in the not so good parts of the castle. I'm fucking like falling off every other 3 seconds. Where am I heading to? Left. I mean, there could be a thing to the right too, but... When I look to the left, I see that there's a break in a fence. I'm gonna go for it. You know, I guess it makes sense to not have you rely on manual saves anymore. When you have... Oh, what is this about? Anyways, when you can't manually save anymore, because we don't have access to Yorta. So that's nice of them. Okay. Am I gonna have to jump across? Wow. Holy shit, I made it? Okay. I don't know where I'm going from here. Interesting. Okay, I could try and swing my way across, but it seems like the closer way for me to go is behind me. But, you know, when we can swing so much... Ow. I might as well attempt things? Okay, fine. Okay, this time we're gonna just go the other way. It's got a ladder here. Obviously... it's there for you if you just barely miss the area. I'm just hoping this isn't actually a makeup place. Like, oh, you went the wrong way and you missed your jump from the chain? Ha 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 ha, silly player. Redo that all over again. Oh god. I don't know where we are. I don't think we've had to jump over two things like that. Okay, no, we're good. Sort of... kind of. If I drop down here, I think I can make the jump. Maybe if I jump... backwards! Ooh, dude, it looked like I plummeted just straight up. But we're good, we are fine. Okay. Well, obviously we can't do anything about this door until we get Yorda. But we can go over here and maybe it leads straight to Yorda. Or at least a weapon. That'd be nice. I don't think the Shadow Demons care about me unless I'm escorting Yorda, though. Hey, boats! Well... it doesn't actually look like I can do anything else besides maybe push the boat. I could try swimming. Oh, wait, nope. There's a path to the left that I didn't mentally acknowledge or see. Is that lightning? Uh-oh. Am I supposed to touch it? It actually looks kind of like a sword. Huh? Whoa! Maybe this is the sword those people had before. Holy crap. What? Okay, I've got a lightning sword. I feel content about life. This is my new companion. I'm gonna name it Yorda. In remembrance of our friend Yorda. And let me guess, it has the power to open up doors. Just like I said early in the game. Although that was more like just thinking of explosions. I just wanted my sword to be able to explode things. But this is cool too! Royal Arms! Neat! Now I want to see what it does to shadow monsters. This thing has to, like, instant kill them. We went pretty far up. We just automatically open up the door. Does it respond to me or do I have to hit them? In that case, it was automatic, but that just could have been because we were coming in from a different angle, so the game just handled it for us. But I have questions. Oh. Wow, would you look at this? We're back in the first area. Oh, that's fucking spooky. What are they having, like, a dance-off? Are they praying or something? Let's go have some fun with our friends, right? Oh, they're all around Yorda, shit! Hey! You guys! Get away from her! I don't know what you're doing, and I don't know why she had all of her color sapped out of her. I mean, that happened earlier, but get out of here! Okay, I am insta-killing them. Yorda, come on, we gotta get out of here! I'm gonna hit you and spark life back into you! It's the same energy that you project, so maybe if we reverse the flow, you'll get it back! Oh gosh, okay. I guess for now I just have to hold the line. You can't have her! You had your chance! And instead of doing anything useful, you put her on a pedestal!
Although with that said, the pedestal could be for something.
Still, get out of here!
Look at them, like, flap their arms to fly. Like, they don't actually have wings. What in the hell?
I mean, you guys can't take her away, so I can leave her a little undefended. And when I say can't take her away, I mean, she's just locked into place. She's almost like stone, honestly. Reminds me when we died to, like, the pulse thing, and it seemed like we got frozen. Okay, we wait until they try to attack us. Then swing! Then swing! Yeah, jerks. Okay, fuck it. I'm just gonna keep on spamming it. Gets results done eventually. They just keep on trying to dodge back, jerks. Okay. There's gotta be something that maybe I can do. I mean, we have that up there. If I could find a way up, that'd be good. Get out of here. What the heck? Whoa. Everything's getting... Are these all the previous horned kids? That were sacrificed? Have they been turned into shadow monsters after... being left to die? You can hear a sound like something activating, and when we turned around, we see that... more and more of this place is lighting up. Okay. Well, that means that there's a finite number of these shadow creatures. I'm sorry, fellow kids. But you're in my way of saving Yorda, and possibly getting out of here. Come on! Attack me! Stop running away! It's like they want to attack me, but at the same time, they just kind of back off immediately. See? One of their weakest moments is to hit them while they're landing. That seems to be a perfect moment to just be like, oh, what's that? You landed and... dead. It works out a lot faster than just waiting for them to... stop jumping back. Although I guess that's what I'm doing, right? Okay. How many more do we have? Quite a few. But it's almost over. I feel kind of bad knowing that they're possibly the kids. I mean, they could be fucking anybody. For all we know, we're the only horned kid that ever existed. And the villagers are talking out of their ass about things. But, more than likely, these are the spirits of those kids. With some kind of legitimate horned energy coming from them through their lives. You little punk. All right. You dodged in a smart way. Going up to a platform that I'm gonna have to climb up to, you little punks. You darn shadow kids! I'll banish you to the Shadow Realm!
once more. Where the heck did the last one go? Ah, he went up to her.
Oh, you can actually see their shadow energy going to the container. Neat. This would be a really weird cutscene if I hadn't noticed all that stuff going on behind me. Okay. So, that didn't do what I was hoping for, which was like, I don't know, restore her energy? Which means I have to go further in. Find out what's behind the big door. Okay, this was automatic. Maybe we can find her mother. And we can have a nice, pleasant conversation. She speaks our language! Even if she doesn't respect us, she's capable of communicating with us. Maybe we can be like, hey, yo, stop doing whatever it is you did to your daughter, yo. And then she can be like, no. And then I hit her with the sword. You know, that's a good solution to the problem. This looks like a throne room for sure. Huh. Do we have to solve a puzzle here? Or do I just walk up to the throne? I am the king of this castle now! I will adopt the power of everyone and save Yoda. And then I will banish the entire village to this place to spruce it up a little bit and actually provide a nice place for us all to live. What? Wait. I guess they assumed I was trying to leave the room. Hey! What's up? What did you do to her? Silence, boy. You're too late. My body has become too old and won't last much longer. But Yoda is going to grant me the power to be resurrected. To be my spiritual vessel is the fulfillment of her destiny. Great, it's one of these kinds of things. The next time her body wakes, Yoda will be no more.
I don't like that proposition.
I have a different one for you. Now put down the sword and leave.
Oh, do you find it to be a threat?
That is what she would want you to do. Lady, I haven't been doing anything that she wants, really. Yeah, we tried. Oh, crap. One of our horns broke. You're a nuisance, boy. Do you want to die that much? I don't actually want to die. I was just hoping the sparkly lightning sword would be pretty effective against you. To be fair, don't know how these things work.
But we can try anyways. Boss battle time? Let's rumble. Whoa! I have a safety zone! We're gonna wait for her to exhaust her shield energy. And then go on the offensive.
Three times? No, alright. Maybe we have to attack her in between anyways. I attack! Yeah! The sword? Oh, ow! Oh, the sword blocks anyways! Oh, hell yeah! As long as I have the sword, we'll be in a good position. I don't know where the sword is right now. Oh, boy. Where'd the fucking sword go? Oh, it's all the way to the left. I didn't see it fly off. Oh, shit! It's actually kind of cool. I think you can just sit behind the sword in general. Okay, I guess I don't actually have to grab it to be safe. I do not know if this is working. I'm just hoping it's working. Yeah, maybe you shouldn't have made a couple of statues in your throne room that are, whoa, immune to your power. I feel like that's counterproductive. Oh, I got it in time. I mean, I might have been safe anyways. Okay, let's try something. Maybe I have to solve a puzzle rather than trying to fight her. I mean, the cutscene should have proved that attacking her is pretty futile, right? So instead, what if I push these towards the center? Will that do anything? No. Okay. Intriguing. Well, I mean, it's a good way to have a safe area that I can actually drag along with me if she starts to use her attack a little bit more often. Well, I mean, I'm safe with this sword anyways. Let's see if... is there anything I could do? Because it's a puzzle game, it would make sense for the final boss battle to be a puzzle that I have to solve. Like, maybe if I stand here and be like a conduit between the two explosions. Yeah, I don't know. I have no idea if this is doing anything. I might just have to legitimately just keep attacking her until her shield breaks. You can't have unlimited energy! As you said, you're getting old and you need Yorda's body to resurrect yourself. I'm gonna wait until she attacks again. She has to be on the safe side. Her shield's gone! Good! Alright! Shit, I don't know where the sword is. Whoa, that's not what I wanted to do at all. We need the safety of this. It must have gotten bit knocked back super far. Maybe if I hold R1, it'll show the sword? Aha! Okay. Ooh, Jesus. Okay. Your shield's gone, lady! I've hit it enough that it's completely vanished. Now I can go on the offensive. Holy shit! Well, spine's broken. Oh, well, our horn's broken too, jeez. I call shenanigans. Yorda not being able to leave the castle ever? There's gotta be something we can do. And if she is unable to leave the castle, then... maybe we can do something instead. Oh, hey! Now they're doing what I thought they were gonna do, restoring her power. Oh shit, what? That's not what I thought was going to happen. So now she's like her mother? Kind of a shadow-imbued creature? Just like our initial vision of her, except when we had our vision of her, I thought that was just gonna be like, you don't know her face yet, so that's why it's all shadowy. You know, when I killed the queen / mother of Yorda, I didn't think that was going to cause the entire place to just crumble completely. I figured that, despite the fact that everything was already in decay, the place was going to be pretty sturdy. But I guess maybe she was holding up half of it. I don't know what that means. Are you saying goodbye? Cause you can't do that. We came back to save you. You can't just set us off on a boat and let yourself die in a crumbling castle? I mean, I guess I don't really have a choice in the matter, but that's not what I wanted at all. How do we even know if the boat's gonna make it back to anywhere? Right? Like, what if we just hit the side of a crumbling wall and then just die with the castle anyways? Physics can be a bitch, you know? Also, nice double rainbows just all the way in the distance as this place is getting collapsed. Feel good moment. And the song is kind of nice, but it's also like a bittersweet moment because Yorda's just stayed behind as like a shadow creature. I mean, that doesn't mean she's gonna have to die, but it's like, what? Okay. So the credits are just like flashback sequences. This all started because, well, nobody was keeping this place maintained, and we were able to break on out. I don't think the same thing could be said for all the other kids. They obviously transformed into shadow things. So I guess that's Eco. There's probably gonna be like an after credit scene, which I'll stick around for, but huh, that was different. That was really, really different. I played this in preparation for The Last Guardian, which is an interesting thing because the stories, I think, are like roughly tied together. I don't know, like I think they're in the same general universe. Maybe not with the exact same characters because they take place maybe long times after everything. Like, Eco takes place supposedly after Shadow of the Colossus. And Shadow of the Colossus ends off with, like, a horned baby being born after your protagonist gains horns throughout the story and gets infused with the shadow of the Colossi's energy. And so maybe that energy kind of progressed downwards through the ages, and it was used by this queen and her people in order to make great castles and rule the land. But in order to keep on abusing it, they had to kind of sacrifice kids born with horns, aka kids born with residual energy from the Colossi or something. That's fucking... It's one of those kind of like make up your own hypothesis, and if it fits with your mind, it works out. But that was interesting. The game was a bit frustrating in a lot of areas. The controls are very clunky, and there were a lot of points where I was trying to do the exact thing I needed for the puzzle, and it wasn't working because of like I needed to be in a very particular spot to activate it. And like I'd be just inches away from that spot and it wouldn't activate, and that was a little bit frustrating. But besides those frustrating moments, the overall experience was interesting and pleasant. It's one of those games where I guess you're not really supposed to really have all the answers thrown at you because you're kind of playing from the main character's perspective. He's just a kid who's been locked up and sacrificed. He's not gonna understand the exact history of the place, and the queen never even went on a monologue to explain it. She's just like, get out of here, kid. She just said that like two times. Get out of here. You don't belong here. Leave the sword, by the way. The only thing that can kill me, leave that, please. Don't take that out of here. That was an interesting moment. And then she just kind of died. I wish that we had more interaction with Yorda, though. It's weird, because I know that did Eco come out in 2001? Holy shit, 15 years? Well, if we're lucky, we survived. Well, we made it out. I have no idea if we can climb a cliff wall or if there's any entrances up along the beach, but we got out. Which I guess is just our general want, our general goal. And holy crap, we actually get to play the after credits scene? What? That's cool. There's just a mist in the distance. Okay. Maybe there's an entrance out of here that I can find, and that'll trigger like the final cutscene of the game. Or maybe this is one of those weird after credits sequences where it just kind of allows us to explore for a little bit, and then it just ends off. Like, it goes, and that was the end. He made it out, but nobody knows what happened. I'm pressing R1 to see if anything happens. He's kind of like calling out, but we can't hear him too much. I think he's actually legitimately saying something. Or like yelling out something.
but it's so faint we can't hear it. Okay. Well, we obviously can't go that way. It's kind of locked off by the rest of the cliff wall, so we just have to keep on exploring out here. This is cool, though. Oh shit, is that Yorda? What? How the hell did she make it out of there? Is she alive? Her finger just moved. Oh! All right. Okay. Well, that's good. That makes it not as, like, bittersweet. Because she actually survived. Yeah, I'll save. Actually, I'll save in slot 4. So we have no idea what's going to end up happening with Yorda and Iko. But they survived. They made it out of the castle. We got the goal that we wanted. I'm pretty happy about that. Okay. Unfortunately, if I stay in the menu here, a credit sequence plays out. So I'm gonna jump into one of my saves. And see if I can just chill out there while I say a little bit more. I don't want to take up too much time, especially because I have a copy of The Last Guardian waiting for me. What's going on here? Oh, it's a new game plus! Huh. Then I guess we'll just sit in the spawn area. I'm gonna get, like, yelled at. Gom, there's actually a new thing that plays during the opening cutscenes after you start New Game Plus. So you shouldn't have skipped the cutscenes, yeah. Did I get anything cool? Anything cool? Players 1. Whoa, can I have played with 2 players? That would have solved so many of my issues. Film effect. Ooh. Oh, cool! You can actually turn on some of the film effects that they had during the cutscenes. That's fun. Okay. Anyways, alright. So, I generally enjoyed the experience for what we got of it, despite the fact that I kind of got stumped on, like, a good portion of the puzzles. A lot of them were easy to solve. In fact, I'd say all of them were easy to solve when you consider the actual ways to solve them. I just always ended up coming to a point where I'm like, oh, I didn't know that was something I could do. And maybe that's just because the game came out in 2001. That was a period of time where you're just supposed to read the manual. And in comparison, I only have the options. I actually don't know if this comes with a manual. I bought a used copy, so I definitely don't have a manual inside the case. And this is a remastered edition, so there might be a PlayStation digital thing like they had for Metal Gear Solid. But I can't use my PlayStation button because I'm on a PlayStation 4 controller, so I can't actually do that. Either way, I wouldn't have looked at it anyways. Oh, we reset my controls completely. What? Or did I just do that by accident? Doesn't matter. So this was an interesting experience, minus the fact that I had a couple of frustrating times. And a lot of, like, long search time trying to find the exact way to solve through the puzzles. The actual exploration aspect of the place was interesting. I don't feel like it was really all that rewarding for half of it, because when you don't know where the hell you're going and what the hell some things are for, I feel like that kind of ruins a bit of exploration in general. Because you get the experience of discovery, but you don't get the kind of relief of going, oh, that's why this area exists in the way it is. It's just kind of like, oh, you're exploring an ancient castle, you're trying to get Yorta out, as well as yourself, and there's something going on at the place, but you don't really know exactly what. Why are there shadow creatures? What are they there for? Who made this place? All the questions just weren't getting answered, and I guess sometimes you just have to accept that as like an, oh well, it was interesting. I was gonna say before we got the after credits thing, I kind of wish that we had a legitimate more, not really cutscenes, but just like ways to interact with Yorta. I feel like in the end, she maybe said like 3 sentences towards us. And I mean, we obviously were never gonna learn what those sentences were, but I wanted more moments where it felt like we were actually building up like a bond or a friendship. And I felt like some of those were a little bit, like it did happen somewhat in gameplay mechanics. Like eventually she did a much better job of like trying to follow you. She would call out to you. If you got stuck in a place for too long, she would point in a direction. And I mean, she only did that for me once, but she still did it. And so I'm aware of that. And so I guess in terms of finding out stuff via the gameplay, they have that sort of nailed down. I still don't like some of the areas of like, oh, you have to swing on the chain. Wouldn't have figured that out without looking it up. A couple other things wouldn't have figured out without looking up, or just like bashing my head on too much. And I think, again, in terms of frustration, there was too much bashing my head on every single thing going, yep, don't know what I'm doing. It's been 30 minutes of me trying to do this jumping puzzle and it's not working, and then I look it up and it turns out I'm doing exactly what I'm supposed to, just not exactly in the right way. And it was funky, but some of those were me, like when I first was here and I thought I had to jump and grab onto the switch. Yeah, that was me, just that was my Shadow of the Colossus play coming in, like, oh, jump and grab. No, just press the action button, player. But that is Eco. It was interesting for what it was. A good portion of it was enjoyable, but I felt like a lot of it was more tense and stressful, if anything. Although, you never really had the threat of death for yourself, minus, like, missing jumps and things. But, like, from the shadow creatures, it was just like, oh, God, please, stop trying to capture Yorta. And it was like I was saying earlier, it's like the entire game was built to be a test around seeing if players were fine with escort missions, and while Eco didn't really, like, see super success, I think it's kind of like one of those cult classic things. Like, every person who's ever played is like, oh, it's such a cool game, you know? And to the point that Shadow of the Colossus was pretty successful, and we're getting The Last Guardian, which is another game from that studio, which was in development for a very long time. And it's going to be the very next thing I play. So, we're going to wrap up here. Thank you guys for watching this Let's Play. Hopefully it was enjoyable. Sorry for being a bit frustrated at some bits, but it was legitimate, like, just 20 to 30 minutes at some points just going, what am I doing? I don't know. But besides that, we went through the game running pretty smooth there, and it was fun. And I'm ready to do another escort game, except this time with a giant dog winged creature thing. That'll be fun. I'll see you guys later.